Wow, look at this market. It has such low reviews. 5 reviews, 10 reviews, 15 reviews. I can really, really compete. And look at the monthly revenue. It's making at least $10,000 a month. Wow, I am going to launch this product and become very rich. So should I launch this? No, you should not launch this. And let me tell you exactly why you should not launch a product with very low reviews. Let's go. Hello, it's me, Karina, again, and welcome back to my Amazon FBA channel. I am here to save you a lot of money, to save you a lot of headaches, because you are going to show me markets with very, very low reviews, but there is a huge key component that you are missing that's actually going to boot you off of the first page, and you're going to get stuck with a lot of inventory and potentially bad reviews. And I really want to break this down for you. So we're actually gonna go into my computer and I'm going to show you markets with very, very low reviews and why you should actually avoid those markets. And it's not for the reasons that you think. And if you stick to the end of this video, I am going to give you a hack. No one does this. How you can see what products not to launch, because you will see, just wait till the end of the video. You're just gonna make, this is a very, very fast way to verify if your product is in this danger zone, and plus avoid other products that might be. So just stick around and you will thank me later. Yes, there is such a thing as low reviews being bad, and I know that you may be confused because all you hear everywhere is, let's get the market with the lowest reviews as possible. And everyone is on the hunt to find markets that have under 75 reviews across the board. And when I say across the board, I mean with the first page of Amazon. Because when we are searching for a product to sell, I want to re-emphasize this many, many times, we are not looking for just one product that is doing well. We are looking for a market that is stable and doing well and is in a similar range where you can penetrate and compete and get a percentage of those market shares. Now, I know that product research is a very stressful component, and it is the number one question that everybody asks, is how to find products and what's the best way to find products. And there are very, very many strategies, but there are a lot of things to look for when you find a potential product to actually launch and to do well in the market. And there are so many things you have to kind of take into account. And I know this. That's why in my Amazon FBA Into a Milli course, I have literally 2 modules that are dedicated to product research itself. So I have the first one, which is the fundamentals, so you know exactly what to look for. And then the second one is actually ways of how to find the products, where I go into very, very detail and break every single little thing down so you don't miss a thing, so you're looking in the right market. And if you're interested in that, the link is down below. And I want to explain to you why, in this particular video, having low reviews is not the very best thing that you can do for your product. There is a lot of caution that comes with it. And although it looks like the best thing ever, the best feeling ever, I feel you, I know how you feel. You find a product with very, very low reviews and you are out to get it. You are just saying, okay, I'm gonna launch it this way, I'm going to go source it, the profit margins on these are huge, it's going to be a success and I'm going to make a lot of money. Why isn't anyone else thinking like this? And trust me, I have almost fallen into this pitfall several times, but thankfully, once you take the product one step further, which is what I teach, you will know exactly how to spot this mistake and avoid it and save yourself thousands of dollars, thousands of time, and then also being stranded with hundreds of units that are not selling and not moving, and then potentially being charged with long-term storage fees in Amazon FBA. And that is a very, very painful feeling of getting stuck with inventory. And I do not want you to get stuck with inventory. So why is having low reviews bad? One simple answer. This is a market with a high turnover rate. What does that mean? What does that mean? Think about this. It is a product, most likely, this is a perfect picture because most of these products that I've seen fall into a very, very similar category. They're more likely than not, they are commodity products, which means not much creativity goes into actually putting them together. It's more kind of pieced together last second, and it comes as is. You don't have to make many modifications. A lot of the times people don't even bundle them, which actually gives people a better offer, and I really, really stress bundling. But most of these items aren't bundled. They're very simple products, very commodity products, me too products, which means everyone is doing the same thing more or less. Maybe a color variation or a size variation, but pretty much you will see that the product is selling the exact same thing. The other category it falls into is that most of the reviews are very, very low. So there'll be under 50 reviews. And then maybe one or two sellers will have very high reviews, but you won't take that into account because you'll think that most of the sellers are selling low. So how do you spot these markets and what does that mean? So first off, these are markets that get rich quick people tend to go after. They see it, all they see is the extension, which shows you the high revenue, the low reviews, and a price that is going to give you a margin. And then they just go for it. They don't put any thought into it. They talk to China, they get the cheapest possible product per unit, they ship it through, and they try to get it selling, right? Whatever way you launch it, most likely they're going to do giveaways, because for these markets, PPC is typically more expensive, because I'll tell you why, because everyone is doing the same product. Everyone is doing the same product. Do you understand? Every single person looks exactly the same. They're trying to rank for the exact same word. No one is providing value, and everyone is launching it in the exact same way, whether it's with pay-per-click, which means it's very expensive because everyone is pretty much bidding the highest possible for that word, or they're using a giveaway service such as Viral Launch to launch the product and just giving away a bunch of units. So when you see them on the first page, they might look like they have a high revenue, but chances are the only reason their revenue is high is because everyone is doing giveaways. Probably literally at least 5 of the 10 sellers on the first page are doing giveaways. So they're completely false and inflated sales that make you think that the product is actually selling well, but it's just highly discounted sales at like 97% off. But Amazon still tracks it as a full price sale. So it might look like it has 10K, 10,000. And you might stay on page one for a little bit, but you're going to get booted off because this is a high turnover rate situation. So literally there are new sellers on a weekly or bi-weekly basis that are doing the exact same tactics. They're paying for a giveaway service so that giveaway service launches the product. They outrank everyone on the first page. They get to the first like 5 spots, but then guess what? Next week comes along, boom, another group of sellers doing the exact same thing, booting that group off. So it is just like a vicious, vicious cycle of people just launching and launching and launching, and no one's actually getting real sales except for probably the top people that have actually been around for a very, very long time on Amazon and have that sales history, so they are able to rank. The bad thing is that with these people, it's a very like aggressive doggy dog world market. So people are going to start getting a lot of negative reviews as well from just other sellers that try to bring the product down. So let me actually go into my computer so I can show you exactly an example of this type of product. Okay, so this is kind of a golden product when it comes to being oversaturated and high turnover rate, so don't do this. There are several examples, but I just wanted to show you one and literally show you exactly how to spot this. And if you feel overwhelmed or confused and you don't know which types of products to look for, again, I say everything in my Amazon FBA course, like it's broken down from every possible thing you can think of. So this is covered in much, much more detail, but I wanted to give it to you as well. So this one is the anti-snoring chin strap. And trust me, I started Amazon over a year ago and I have seen this back then and to this day, and it falsely looks like a very good market, but trust me, it is not. I personally know people that have been in this market, got to the first page, started making money, and literally in a month were completely demolished and just booted off. So do not do this. So it looks like easy. It looks so easy. But again, it fits everything that I was talking about. It's, if you can see here, it's literally the exact same product. I mean, there is literally nothing you can do in this product to make it different. Except for using a picture. Like this one used an attractive lady and everyone else uses a very unattractive mannequin head. And like trying to do it in lifestyle, which is totally against terms of service, but they're just trying to do everything to make themselves noted. But it's literally the exact same product. Like, I'm not like, you obviously you can see it. And then let's just run the extension on it so I could show you how it might look appealing. It has a 4-star product store. I don't really pay attention to that, but I just look at the monthly revenue, right? It looks pretty good. Like, there's people that are doing $37,000, $8,000, $7,000, $18,000. They're all pretty much like selling well on the first page. And then when it gets lower, it's a little bit dispersed. Some people are still, even on like after the first page, someone's doing 12,000, 9,000. Then we look at the price. It looks definitely like it would have a profit. If we were to look this on Alibaba, this product is probably like $2, and it's so lightweight that everyone is interested in this. It could be airshipped for like pennies, like probably 50 cents. So your margins on this are very, very high. And this is what I'm talking about. You look here in the review section and you see 0 reviews, 0 reviews, 16 reviews, under 100, 14, 23, like these such low numbers of reviews, right? And it's like, okay, he's doing 0 reviews, he's doing $4,000 in sales. Even the guy doing like 37,000 only has 179 reviews, which to me, I would completely compete with this if it was in any other market. If I saw a market where someone was selling $37,000 worth of things with only 179 reviews, you bet your butts I'm going to be competing in it. But in this case, I'm gonna show you why you shouldn't. So the thing is, the next step, you wanna actually study, like, hey, why is this the case? Why is this person with 0 reviews on the first page? So what I'm actually going to do is open up some of the competition, and I wanna see what their deal is. Why are they doing well in sales, and why do they have low reviews, right? Because that's confusing to me, right? Okay, so I opened a few up, and we go in here, and we want to check out their listing history. So you can either have Keepa or Helium 10. Keepa is you pay for it, and then Helium 10 is free. So it shows you basically the amount of time that this product has been. So right here, we can look at the time. I have it set to all time. So we see that they launched 2 weeks ago, okay? 2 weeks ago, that's pretty, pretty recent, okay? That's alarming. Let's look at the next person. What's their deal, okay? They have 23 reviews, quite low, they're selling well. So when did they launch? And a lot of the times, the graph won't even populate for this because they have launched so recent, 49 days ago. Really, really recent. This graph isn't like pulling things up, but just still very recent. Let's look at the next person. 7 days ago, okay? He has 16 reviews, so clearly these are inflated reviews, most likely not from anyone that's actual customers, and most likely if he is doing high numbers, he is probably still in the giveaway phase. So he has only been around for 7 days, so he's launching his product. He's just one of those unlucky people that thought that getting to the first page is going to give him success, but it's not. And then let's look at this last person. Again, 49 days. So they're very, very recent. Some, of course, are like a little bit over a month. I guarantee if we analyze everyone on the first page, there are going to be a lot of sellers that are in the low few weeks. But that's just a very, very, very dangerous game to play. And you should always check how long your competitors have been in the market for. Trust me. Trust me, do that. By the way, before I go any further, please hit the subscribe button, click the notification bell, because it is just fun. Why not? I post daily videos, I give you guys info, I save you money, I save you time, so please subscribe. Thank you. But anyways, actually, that's going to be it for the rest of the video. I just wanted to let you know to avoid markets like these and how to easily spot markets like these, because it literally takes 30 extra seconds to check how long each seller has been on. And before we get going, I told you that I would share a secret trick on how to find out if your product is potentially in an oversaturated market so you can not make that mistake. And this is a very, very interesting hack, okay? So you are actually going to be looking at a deal website to see if there are any products that look like yours or if there are a few that are being launched, okay? So this is very, very interesting. So a deal website, for example, like JumpSend, it helps sellers do giveaways, right? So you can see all of these deals are very, very highly discounted items. Sometimes you will even see things here for like less than a dollar or basically essentially free. So this is a way of basically bargain hunters go on these sites and they pick whatever they want. but they don't know that these are Amazon sellers trying to launch. So hypothetically, you found a product and you are uncertain if it's something that is oversaturated or being given away a lot, and you want to avoid that. So what you would do is actually go to this deal site and scroll and see if a potential product that you are thinking about launching is on here, because a lot of the times it will be. And I have been researching markets when I first started out and I wanted to launch something, and I would refer to here and I would literally see like five of the same products, and that actually happens a lot. If it's a trend, a lot of the times the product will be in here. So you just want to do a little scrolly scroll and see if there are products that look like yours. And on top of that, if there is a hot trend that's going on, there will most likely be a lot of sellers that are selling the exact same product and giving it away at the exact same time. And if you see that, don't think to go after the trend, avoid the trend. So that's your hack, and all the links are down below. Follow me. I'll see you in my next video.